Dear friends, we welcome you as we celebrate the great feast of our Blessed Mother, Our Lady of Consolation. Our Lady of Consolation is one of the most beloved titles of Mary in the Augustinian order. The other titles of Mary, which have a special place in the devotions and prayers of the Augustinians all over the world, are Mary, Our Lady of Good Counsel, Mary, Our Lady of Grace, and Mary, Our Lady of Help. The Augustinian devotion to Mary, Our Lady of Consolation, has its roots in the religious experience of Saint Monica, the mother of Saint Augustine. Monica was deeply saddened by her son's wayward life and his not embracing the Christian faith. One day, she was praying before the image of Our Lady with much tears when she experienced the consoling presence of Mary. In her prayer, she saw Our Lady handing her the end of a black belt, while Augustine, her son, also held at the other end of the belt. That is why the image of Our Lady of Consolation in many pictures shows the Blessed Mother in the middle, Saint Monica on the left side holding the belt, and Saint Augustine on the right side holding the other end of the belt. In Monica's prayer, Our Lady of Consolation consoled and enlightened her heart, so that she was filled with a spirit of trust and confidence in the mercy of the Lord for the conversion of her son, Augustine. With this religious experience of Mary's consolation, Saint Monica in turn became a messenger of consolation to all mothers who are undergoing afflictions in their married life. And likewise, to all sons who find themselves confused in their life of faith and yet sincerely seeking for God. Today, Our Lady of Consolation accompanies all the Augustinian order and religious congregations in the search for God, in their challenges, trials, and afflictions, as the source of joy and consolation in their religious life. With the consolation and joy of Mary amidst our afflictions, let us offer this holy rosary for the needs of our confused and afflicted world, especially for the healing and wholeness of all those infected who are suffering and dying from COVID-19 virus in the whole world. Blessed Mary, Our Lady of Consolation, pray for us.
Thank you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Blessed is he who has believed, because the things promised her by the Lord shall be accomplished. And Mary said, My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaid. For behold, henceforth all generations shall call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is from generation to generation on those who fear him. He has shown might with his arm, he has captured the proud in the conceit of their hearts, he has put down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Now at the hour of our death. Amen.
Amen. Mary, full of grace, the Lord.
from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. It came to pass, while they were in Bethlehem, that the days for her to be delivered were fulfilled. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes. As she laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds in the same district. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood by them. Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which shall be to all the people. For today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you, who is Christ the Lord. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men of good will. And behold, Magi came from the east, and entering, they found a child with Mary, his mother. And falling down, they worshipped him, and they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And Mary kept in mind all these things, pondering them in her heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Thank you.
from the Holy Gospel of the Father to change to you. When Jesus was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem according to the custom of the feast. And when they were returning, the boy Jesus remained in Jerusalem, and his parents did not know him. They returned to Jerusalem in search of him, and after 3 days they found him in the temple. He was sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who were listening to him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. "Son, why have you done this to us? Behold," he says, "your father's eyes have been seeking you. How is it that you saw me? Did you not know that I must be about my father's business?" And they did not understand the word that he spoke to them. And he went down to them and came to Nazareth and was subject to them. And Jesus advanced in wisdom and age and grace before God and man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come.
Thank you.
Christ, hear us. Yeah.
God is the Lord of the Father. We give you the Lord.